appointees or?
Yes, we have provided you with a list of the appointees that are coming up.
Let's go back a second. This is about our authorities and appointees. Have y'all looked at the DCA website lately? What authorities it says Lyles County is involved in?
I noticed that they redid their website.
They did. It shows we're involved in the residential care facility for the elderly authority of Lyles County. Anybody know what that is? Pardon? And Parks Rec's not on here. And neither is the tourism authority. Should they be? Or does it matter?
It's because they're joint authorities or what?
No, I mean, it should be, if you pull it up, but a lot, some of these are joint, multi-jurisdictional authorities already, like the airport authority and the industrial authority.
All of our services are on the service delivery documents submitted to DCA.
Well, I just, like I said, I was looking at the authorities of the day, and I'm just covering, like I said, I don't know, are we part of the land bank authority? It's not on here either. So, I mean, I'm just, like I said, this is something we need to, if somebody's looking at Lyles County and, you know, just know more information that we need to make sure is correct. Anyway, I just.
If y'all would look over those appointees, those particular areas that have board members that will be coming up for consideration or positions for consideration that are currently filled by these individuals, y'all will note there's still a vacancy on that public facilities authority and Clay's seat on that will be coming up in May.
Mr. Kreiner doesn't know it just yet, but he's going to be reappointed.
It's fine. I think I've been to two meetings since I've been on the board. When you just hadn't had any reason, I guess I have one.
These others are just for y'all's consideration and y'all to be aware of. This is an example of something that would be helpful y'all to have for you if it's on that iPad so that y'all would be thinking of individuals that might want to solicit their involvement in this, since your process is that individuals submit to us, we don't advertise these openings. So. All right.
On these appointees, do we have people that come in that are in our agenda book? We need everybody to fill out an information sheet so that we'll know who we're dealing with. Because there's sometimes there's not any information sheets in there. Somebody says, well, you know, I'm not what they saw, so who is that? We'll see it happen, or she it happen, or whatever. I think that would be very helpful.
And I'll tell you what gets looked, and that's easy to do. Like if we know in advance, but whenever people come up, like between the work session and the regular meeting, it is super hard to get in touch with them in time to get them to get anything in.
Can we put it off to another meeting?
That's totally up to y'all if you want to table it.
Until we have that information. I mean, I think we need to take these appointments serious, even though maybe only two meetings a year or every how long.
Oh, I agree. I think everyone's sick of, you know, any appointment we make is.
Well, I do agree now, but I'm gonna probably say something that Mr. Pritchard is thinking, but he's not going to say. We talk about these appointments, and we've also had the opportunities at meetings to make appointments, and then there's nobody there that's actually been prepared or actually brought forward a name or page to be able to get that information, and then we will table that particular appointment until the next meeting, and inevitably we get back to the work session of the same meeting 2 weeks later, and there's still no names. So the key is here is that we should make a better effort as commissioners to look at these appointments that are coming up and then search your database that you may have within your contacts in the community to see who would be available. Then it's your responsibility to contact that individual and say, do you have an interest? If that individual then has that interest, they need to get with Paige so that that information sheet can be completed. But that's our responsibility.
Yeah, you're absolutely right.
How quickly would we know if these people are interested in being reappointed?
Well, given that they're all, you know, by mid-year and it's, you know, pushing towards the end of February, we can reach out to them. So Brandy can go ahead and reach out to all of them. Some of them, we hear from Chris Yarbrough, has taken on additional responsibilities, and he's made a recommendation for someone to take his place, that's someone that he knows. And I'm not saying that that person is a bad recommendation. I'm just saying that you all might have someone else that you would rather nominate for this. I think what we could do is go ahead and see if these people are interested in being reappointed. And at the same time, if you all want to talk to people that you would like to recommend, and you know, don't wait till May or June to give us those names, so that Sabrina's got plenty of time to track everyone down and get those forms filled out, then we can do that. It's just, again, the ones we might not get is if there's a wild card between the work session and the regular meeting.
I think that another good way that can be accomplished, I do know that some of the boards and authorities do a real good job of when one of their members is coming up for reappointment, they will go ahead and send a letter to Mr. Pritchard letting him know that that individual either no longer has an interest or does have an interest in continuing to serve. So I think that would be important to us. So maybe send a letter to the chairman of each one of the boards, you know, that we have, encouraging them to make sure that gets done, and that way you get that. It's a lot easier to contact them and have the board's responsibility to give you the feedback than it is for staff to try to run down some of these board members as individuals.
Well, that gives us the opportunity to communicate with the chairman, for instance, and find out a little bit more about, you know, if it's a reappointment for the attendance and kind of get some feedback from the chairman. But I agree. I mean, every board has a chairman, so communicating with them, I think, is vital.
I can take it further, again, because what I feel like that probably a chairman of a particular board's responsibility is, just because that individual wants to serve doesn't mean that individual is an effective board member. That chairman needs to make that recommendation of whether or not that individual should be appointed or not. I don't have any problem whatsoever putting that responsibility on the chairman of those boards. Give us a recommendation.
One board that does not have a chairman, but that we do need some recommendations on, is the Dangerous Dog Board. We need to add a couple of members to that, and the difficult thing about it is it's one of those that's just like the one you said you guys have only had a couple of meetings because there's not been a need to meet. The ordinance has a process that is part of state law that we have to adopt locally, that says that if a dog has certain aggressive behaviors towards people or other animals, or bites, attacks, or kills people or other animals, that we have to bring that animal before the Dangerous Dog Board. And it's not a situation where we have a lot of discretion. If that aggression, bite, or attack meets the definition of the law for that, then we have to do it. We used to have one of these a year, maybe 5 years ago.
Maybe.
Right now, and we'll talk about this after lunch when we talk about Target Zero, but right now we're averaging a dog bite every 2.86 days. So the number of aggressive dogs and the nature of these attacks and the severity of these attacks have increased significantly. Right now we've got Dangerous Dog Board meeting probably 8 times a year. And we used to only see them one. And sometimes when they meet, they're meeting on more than one case. We've got a case coming up on Wednesday where a child was attacked, and there's going to be plastic surgery involved, and that child's going to be scarred forever. And this is a dog that the board has already deemed dangerous, that the owner was not maintaining properly, that was allowed to get to a child, and there was a second attack. So, and there's a process for upping the requirements and designation from a dangerous dog to a vicious dog. So if you all know people who are interested in the animal community or being a part of that process, then there's not a chairman for that board. We just need some input from you all.
Has anything been done? Is it in the system, the fellow that came to our last complaining about that?
I can tell you all you would like to know and more about that situation.
Yes. I just hadn't heard anything
yes.
when he said we'll look into that.
Yeah, I can't.
Hadn't heard anything.
Yes.
So, as far as your chairman on that.
how many people serve on that board?
We can have up to 7, I think. Right now, we've got 3 to 4. The way the law is written is that a quorum is 2, and you've really got to have more than 2 people there, because if it gridlocks, then you're there until they talk it out. So we like to have at least 3 there. But the law also says that board has to meet within 10 days of the dog owner being served with paperwork and not accepting the designation as a dangerous dog. So it gets a little squirrely as far as availability goes and schedules go, because you know, we're not sometimes giving people a lot of notice that they've got to clear their calendar. And sometimes we're done in an hour, and sometimes it takes all afternoon. It just depends on how complicated the situation was, whether or not there were any witnesses.
But ideally, we need 5 folks on
yes.
there, and we've got 3 currently with one just...
Well, these are the ones that are up for reappointment. Mr. Richard Joyner, who is a city marshal, he's also on this board, and he is fantastic. And he brings to the table a lot as far as his experience in working with the public, but also he's never owned a dog. And, you know, sometimes whenever you have those of us who've always owned dogs and who've owned multiple dogs, you know, we look at things from, you know, one perspective. But Mr. Joyner is a great balance to that, because he doesn't, you know, he doesn't have that experience. So he asks a lot of good questions.
Who's the other member? We've got Amanda, Ted, Richard. Bennett has moved out of town.
Right. Now, she is, she's not totally moved, but she is moving. So she's going to not be available to
who's
be reappointed.
Who's the fifth?
Right now, we have, I'll have to text Sabrina and say, whoever the other one is, they don't show up very often.
Right.
Dawn. So we do need, you know, we need some input there.
Good to have on there. He scares the hell out of everybody. Dogs.
You know it.
And if any of you are ever interested in how the process works and you'd like to come in and sit on the dangerous dog board here, and you're welcome to do that. It's a new appreciation for that process.
Have an application or something, papers filled up on these. I think they should come to the meeting at time for the council to get introduced.
Oh, well, that just makes me look about that, doesn't it?
You're about them coming to the meeting.
Yeah. All right, then we just go through that.
I would encourage you to do it at your work session if you're going to do it, as opposed to having them there at your work session, at your regular meeting.
Better.
And this, I'll just enjoy watching people's face come on.
Don't get appointed.
And
your dreams are crushed.
Kind of get up and stomp out or leave or whatever.
Yeah, so, I think you're right. If you won't do that, then you come be, stop, then you come introduce yourself at work session.
Okay.
That they show up for the regular meeting is their own fault.
That's their own fault.
Okay. Any any discussion on that particular issue? Or if there's not, then we'll go ahead and adjourn for lunch.
Does anybody have any update on Matt McClain? Or is it
something you want to share with anybody? Is that clear?
I know.